Horizon post-human live experience.
Bring me the Horizon pop-up shop.
Yo, 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 stop the show.
What is up, guys? Happy New Year. Welcome to the first video we're putting out this year. And we are off to Cardiff to see Bring Me the Horizon for the my first time and Beth's
second time.
So yeah, I don't know what we're in for. I've seen videos online, people going to their concerts. Seems pretty lit. First time for me. We are now, it's 5:30. We're gonna travel up to Cardiff. Check into our travel lodge. Tomorrow we're gonna have a chill look around Cardiff before we see Bring Me the Horizon at the Utilita Arena. Is that what it's called?
I say Utilita.
Utilita Arena. So yeah, looking forward to it. We'll show you all around the merch. It's the first of their UK tour. So yeah, a little exclusive for anyone that's going to check it out for the rest of the tour in the different locations. But yeah, let's get straight into the video.
So guys, we're just outside of Bristol now, doing our final charge of the car. Shocking charging situation. They have two grid serve chargers. One of them is out of use, but luckily it's been very quiet on the way up. Not a lot of people on the roads. So yeah, been pretty chill. Started like snowing a bit. So yeah, that wasn't chill. But yeah, it seemed to just be little flurries here and there. About 40 minutes away from Cardiff now. I'll let you know when we get there, check out the little hotel room, and yeah, settle in for our first night in Cardiff.
Guys, we've made it here to Cardiff. Gonna back check into our travel lodge now.
Hello, hello. 326. That's the number. We stay right here in the travel lodge, Central Cardiff. Give you a little room tour, shall I? Put a nice choice of light switches. Nice bathroom. Let's get you on the wide angle. Toilet. Mirror there. Hello. Got your sink. Stand up shower. Got your accessible handle, got your drying rail, and the towels out there. Yeah. There we go, on a close one, got towels, your nice double bed. Is that USB? USB's on the side. You took your TV, mirror. Got my number one fan right here. Remote, tea and coffee facilities. Let's have a gander at the view.
You can't see.
Oh, we've got a little, let's see, just a tiny bit of the street view there. We're looking straight over to another building. See my reflection.
So yeah, not too shabby, standard travel lodge lodgings. So yeah, gonna settle in, relax, get a good night's sleep, and we'll have our nice morning day in Cardiff before Bring Me the Horizon. Catch you guys tomorrow. Peace.
Good morning, and welcome to the official day of Bring Me the Horizon. So yeah, just got up from our lovely night in the travel lodge. We were actually next to some pretty lit club venue, so we had that thumping all night till about 3 a.m. But finally got to sleep, so yeah, we're gonna grab some breakfast and we're going to Timmy Horton's, which me and Beth haven't had before in the UK. I tried it over in Canada, where it's obviously most popular. So yeah, we're gonna give UK Tim Horton's a whirl for breakfast.
Alright guys, so here's our breakfast. I went for a vanilla iced latte. I got a
breakfast, Tim Horton's big breakfast wrap. Looks pretty banging. Breakfast also comes with cheeky hash brown. What do you go for, Beth?
I got a veggie muffin, which I've never had before. That was quite well. With cheese and egg and brown sauce and a hash brown and a gingerbread latte.
Wow, wait. Yeah, and it's pretty reasonable pricing as well. They had a deal where if you buy any drink, you get a breakfast item for £1. So as you can see, that came to £10.34, which is amazing value. So yeah, gonna dig into this now and let you know how it was.
Right guys, just finished up our Tim Hortons breakfast there. That was amazing. Big shout out to Tim Hortons Cardiff. Highly recommend. Great value. Yeah, basically a tab of two breakfasts, two coffees. So yeah, I'm giving Tim Hortons a 9 out of 10. Beth, what are you giving it?
Giving it 7. It was nice and good value for money, but I mean, the taste was like, okay. This is good though.
Right guys, we've now walked over and we're now by the famous Wales Millennium Centre. Core memory I have attached to this place is, do you remember that episode of Doctor Who when they're sort of outside this thing?
Rip something.
That's what I remember that from. So the reason we've popped over to this side of town is because there's actually a Bring Me the Horizon merch pop-up shop. So Beth wants to see if she can get some merch. So yeah, just went over here, we see a bit of a line situation. So yeah, we'll take you along for the tour, see if we can get some merch. So you probably can't see with the sun, but the merch situation is in this church looking building. As you can see, there is quite a little line forming, so we're going to get over there as quick as possible, see if we can get in and show you guys what merch is available. Excited?
Yeah, my eyes are all watering. Just looking at my eyeliner.
Very chilly out here. And we are in the Bring Me the Horizon pop-up shop. You can have a little browse at the gifts. So here we've got some cool designs. The critical clothing guy in me is not happy to see the generic sort of print. So yeah, you're paying for just the graphics on these.
I'm getting to look at those.
Cool. Not the zip up though.
A
guys, 2 hours later and we are out. We've had the Bring Me the Horizon merch pop-up experience. Beth's got her hoodie. What's the sound in the back? Next gen, which is the tour we're going to this evening. So yeah, it was expensive as most band tour merch is, but you know, when you're so emotionally invested in something, you know, it is worth it and you do see the value. So yeah, it's exciting to pop the hoodie. I enjoyed just the experience, queuing up, going into the little random church-like venue. So yeah, it was a cool little pop-up experience. Did take a while, is a bit expensive, but that is what is to be expected with these kind of things. And Beth is very happy with her brand new Bring Me the Horizon hoodie. There was merch pop-up exclusives. That hoodie was an exclusive for the pop-up. There are exclusives for the venue as well, but we weren't sure what the situation would be like there. If it's going to be a shit show, Beth might not have liked the merch they had at the arena tonight.
So they might have sold out. I found this on that.
So played it safe, popped at the pop-up, and you know, seemed a bit silly waiting 2 hours not to get anything. So yeah, everyone was very pleasant in the pop-up. Great customer service. Very well-run little event there. So yeah, and I'm going to continue our day before the big concert tonight.
Here we go, guys. First try on of the hoodie. Flex it for us.
Nice fit.
Baggy fit, like nice. And we've got the next gen on the back. There we go. Stopped here in...
Where are we at?
Crazy Club.
We've just popped in Crazy Club. A little drink down by the Cardiff docks, that's what you call it. Yeah, chill vibe. First drink of the day. First beverageino. Gone for a cheeky BMTH. Best got a little cocktail. Cheers, bub. Lovely. So just headed back to Cardiff Central now. Bit of retail therapy at Bath and Body Works. Beth got a bit excited because this is normally an American-only thing, so classic Brits getting exciting about something we don't see that often. But yeah, let Beth have a look in here, she'll like that. Get some winter candy apple. This is body cream, now £9. Yeah, so I'll meet around here, then we're going to head back to the hotel, freshen up for tonight, go out some food, then Bring Me the Horizon, yeah. Right guys, we're all freshened up, dressed, and ready to head out for tonight's performance at the Utilita.
Utilita.
Ready to head out for the Utilita Arena to see Bring Me the Horizon. We're all ready, Beth's got a new hoodie on. Boom, rocking the merch for the show. So yeah, we're gonna go grab some food before and then slowly make our way to the arena, scope out the vibe. Because yeah, there's three support acts before the main event. What are the three support acts?
Oh, I've forgotten the first one. Static Dress and Bad Omens.
And another one.
Cassiette,
apparently. So yeah, we'll scope out the vibe, see how busy it is, then decide when we're gonna head in. But yeah, wanna get slightly litty before we fully get in. So yeah, we're gonna scope out what the drinks vibe is, how we're gonna achieve the perfect vibe for Bring Me the Horizon. Catch you outside. Here is our first sighting of the Utilita Arena. You can see a bit of commotion, a bit of a queuage here. It seems like the diehards are gagging to get in at opening, which is to be expected. Cool. But yeah, I reckon we just let this bit get in before we even attempt it.
Yeah.
Let the diehards have their
moment. These are like gates. We're just general admission, so we're probably in another place anyway.
Yeah. Alright, we'll get some food, then come back and suss it out once the doors have opened and the main crowds have got in. Got their barrier spot, and yeah, it is very cold, extremely cold. So yeah, we're gonna grab some food and suss out the vibe.
Right guys, so we are in ZZ's for our little pre-gig meal, starting off with a Meantime IPA. Instantly annoyed that it wasn't on draft, but hey ho, we move. Ice cold glass, which I'm liking, that kind of makes up the thing.
Beth's gone for a Cornish orchard, yeah. Raspberry and elk flower. They've given us some little pasta crisp things. We've ordered our food, so I'll show you when that comes, but in the meantime, I'll enjoy this. Here we are then, guys. I went for this chicken pasta dish. It looks pretty good. Beth's gone for... what you got there?
Just like a veggie pizza, like
veggie
cheese, caramelised onions,
feta
cheese, I think.
Looks pretty good. We're going to dive into this, get filled up. Then we're going to head to the gig. We've got a little sharer extra here. We've got this little bread platter. We've got some little breads there and a mixture of dips. I think this is like a beetroot hummus, garlic aioli, and like a chilli, salsa-y kind of thing. Yeah, served on this lovely little brick, this wooden panel here. It's very nice. This is really good. Just had some of this chili though, it's very spicy. How's your pizza?
Good, I'm glad I didn't put that over my pizza because it is quite hot.
Yeah. But yeah, we'll finish this off and then give you our little ratings afterwards. Cheers. There we go then, first beverageino. £7.90 right there, boys. Beth went for a VK, which was like £6, I think. So yeah, here we go. Entrance to the arena. Excited.
Oh, we can sit here. What? How weird.
It's like a church hall compared to the weekend we were at.
I literally wouldn't even care if I was here.
Very nice, intimate venue. I mean, compared to the last gig we went to was the weekend at London Stadium. So yeah, pretty chill. So guys, the first support act is coming on now. This is the first support act.
They don't care about you, none of them. They don't Cardiff, are you ready for the greatest night of your life? Analyze your reaction levels. Status, weak as fuck. Let's try that again. Are you ready for the greatest night of your life? Excellent. Thank you for volunteering in the Next Gen Research Program. Your commitment and ultimate sacrifice to our all-important mission will not be forgotten. I'm Eve, a state-of-the-art advanced research engine, entrusted with the greatest mission in human history, the salvation of mankind. Tonight, I will be observing your biopsychosocial activity and collecting data to further our research on NextGen, the next stage of human evolution. Please wait a moment while I run some final diagnostic checks. Scanning for mosh pits. No significant mosh pits found. Please, open this place up. Contraband detected. Bring Me the Horizon have a zero tolerance policy on drugs. Those in possession of any illicit substances are advised to consume them now. Diagnostics check complete. Bring Me the Horizon would like to thank you once again for being here tonight. I also hope you enjoy tonight's performance, as it will be the last one you ever attend. I'm sorry my research was conclusive. Mankind is a plague on this earth that must be destroyed. So, Cardiff, are you going to live your lives like you're ready to die?
We'll be right back. some space.
We got a good guy, Ollie Sykes here. There's an injury alert. Good guy, Ollie Sykes, has stopped the show.
There we go, we got some marshals making a pass.
No, just keep the power flow down, sorry.
We got a path.
I need to know everything you know.
We don't know much currently, but they call it Project Kingslayer.
Yo, stop the show.
We
got an injury. Eve, shut the fuck up. Is everyone okay? Yeah. Can you make some space then? Make some space for the injured person, please. Pre-record it tonight, get it done.
Okay, let's do it. Which song would you like to record tonight?
It hasn't got a name yet, but it's the one that sounds
oh,
a little bit...
Oh, I know which one. You mean Scream.
No! No, I got Eve!
Oh, do you mean this one?
Turn it off! Eve, you daft bitch!
Sorry. Is it Limousine?
No! 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 For fuck's sake! Yes.
Got you.
Thank you. Honestly.
Extracting vocal part now. Please wait a moment. Recording complete. Good job, guys.
You guys are going to be on the album! Woo!
Yeah.
You guys are still here? You really want to hear more of this shite? Jesus Christ. You people really are all doomed.
Guys are the sole reason we are alive, so thank you so fucking much. Don't be modest, make some noise for yourself. This really is our last song. It's called Throne, and if you don't lose your fucking minds, you are a knobhead. Everybody go! The most fun you've ever had in your life, but I just trust me.
What's your initial thoughts, Beth?
Huh?
Initial thoughts?
I
want to
not end. Where have they gone? They were so good.
Out of 10?
11.
There we go, the cleanup process has begun. The ocean of plastic cups.
What are you waiting for?
Waiting for Ollie
Sykes,
but I don't think he's coming.
Been here a little while, haven't we? No sign of the man himself from Sheffield. Right guys, it's now the morning after Bring Me the Horizon. We are well rested, ready to go, about to check out the hotel, but we're going to get Beth's final thoughts on the concert. Beth, what did you think of Bring Me the Horizon?
Just so good, amazing, very good chat from Ollie, very good, all the good songs.
Anything you didn't do you were slightly disappointed about?
There's a couple of songs, but they're just like my personal favourites, not like...
What are those?
Sugar Honey, what's it called? Sugar Honey, Ice and Me. I forgot what it's called. He didn't do Ludens. He didn't do Bite My Tongue. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, and he didn't do Mother Tongue. But I knew he wouldn't do that because that's one of my favourite Mother Tongues. Yeah. But it was very good.
Very good. Overall, as a first timer, he sang all the like popular ones that I'd heard of, and those were pretty vibes when those came on. A couple of injuries during the concert, and he was very prompt at stopping the show. The marshals came in, cleared everything away, and then it continued. So yeah, in terms of safety, very good, very well run event. I enjoyed the size of the venue. It didn't feel too big. There was no point where I was like crushed. We didn't go into the mosh pits or anything, just because they were like quite far away from us, and it would have been a nightmare if we lost each other. And yeah, considering there's a couple of injuries, it sounds like the moshers were moshing pretty hard. But anyway, we're going to check out the hotel now and then go grab some food and then hit the road back to Cornwall. All right, we've got some drinks to start here at Oaxaca. What are you going for, Beth?
Passion fruit and hibiscus mocktail.
Then I've gone for the, what's it called? It had a silly name. Mocktail. The Oaxaca Colada. No, that's the alcoholic one. Oh, there you go, the Mocolada. Looks pretty good. A little pineapple garnish. Oh, yes. That is lovely.
I'm gonna try it. I don't know.
So to start us off here at Oaxaca, we got some veggie nachos, which look very nice indeed. So yeah, we're gonna nom these down before they bring out our mains. Can we give us a quick taste test? Good. Breaking news, I just got hooked up with these pork tacos. Apparently they were made extra in the kitchen. So yeah, gonna give these a whirl. Yeah, I was lucky, wasn't it? You can't have it, can you?
Unfortunately.
The vegetarian will stay to the veggie nachos. So guys, Oaxaca Cardiff. Starters have gone down a treat. I was randomly hooked up with some free tacos, which was amazing. Had the pork tacos, really good. Beth finished off the rest of the veggie nachos. Again, really enjoyed those. So guys, I've got a beef burrito here. And Beth, what have you gone for?
Mushroom enchiladas.
Mushroom enchiladas. Looks very good. Comes with a bit of rice, bit of salad. So yeah, gonna give this a whirl and give you guys our review. Scratch that, my order was wrong. I actually ordered the ultimate burrito, which meant it came with all this sauce, cheese, bit of feta, guacamole, and my tortilla chips. So yeah, slight mess up with the order there, but never mind. So to upgrade to this version, it was an extra £3.50, but actually the value in that, because it's quite the showstopper there with your tortilla chips. Beth's loving enchiladas. So yeah, I'm gonna dig into this now and let you know how it is. We're back at Tim's. I went for an Oreo crepe this time. Beth just got a regular coffee crepe.
Vanilla
coffee crepe. Then we treated ourselves to a couple of donuts. I got like a maple glazed. Beth got a filled maple glaze. But yeah, we're gonna hit the road now back to Cornwall with our Tims. Cheers.
Right guys, and just like that, we are back home. We had an amazing time in Cardiff. Bring Me the Horizon was an absolute ball. Had a great time, 10 out of 10. It's my first time, whether it was your first time, your fifth time, your 50th time going. Yeah, definitely an absolutely great show. If you're going at any of the dates for the rest of the tour, have a great time. I had an absolute ball. Yeah, Beth, what would you give it out of 10, the whole experience? 10 out of 10 from Beth. That was her second time seeing them live. Yeah, and we're going to be seeing them later in the year at some point, so that should be another video coming out soon. But yeah, hope you enjoyed the first video of the year. Lots more adventures coming up with me, Beth, and some special guests who will be joining us along the way. Hope you enjoyed the video. Drop a like, drop a subscribe, leave a comment if you're going to any of the shows or if you're at the Cardiff show. Let us know what you thought. We'll catch you in the next one. Peace.